And we're back. Trying to figure out why I couldn't get the system turned on. It's because I plugged the HDMI from my Xbox into my... that's the wrong thing. Into my PlayStation. I needed to switch it from the Xbox into the Elgato. A capture card. Hey, Size 16, how you been? I've done Insanity for all three games on Infiltrator, which I think is the easy mode, and Vanguard, which is, I think in Vanguard's the hardest in all three. Might not be completely true. Yeah, sure. If I'm going to be the only one who understands it, the people who've played it already are going to get it, but that's fine. I'll clear it if I think it's too obvious. Thank you for asking. May as well use all of his MP when we're out here, huh? Meteor just hits enemies. Water is actually a lot of damage. We kind of screwed up the party. The whole point of this dungeon is you're supposed to bring people who do not use magic because magic is disabled there. But I forgot and I brought two magic users, so they're essentially going to be item users. I do, Raisa. Yep. I'm multi-streaming to Hitbox and Twitch right now. We'll be doing that until I, you know, achieve a partnership with one of the three giants at the moment. Oh yeah, yeah, I know about that. No worries, Size 16, good to see you. That'll be my first time seeing it. Look at all that leveling up. I have to look at everybody's items now. I'm working on paying attention to Hitbox chat as well. There's a lot less foot traffic there, but I haven't, you know, spent 6 months building a regular audience there either, so we'll see. We just want to keep the judo uniform on. We're learning accuracy plus. Pretty good. We'll finish learning that before we switch it. If there's anything else to learn here. It's here. It's here. Just working on auto haste. Auto life. Learn jelly for him? I already has it. Dark hat. I could do the gamble defense. Probably never gonna equip it. So learning haste. There. We need body temp. Already learned jelly, so we can switch to the magician robe. And already have Phoenix. Awesome. Don't really care about mini. Level up would be nice. Anything that teaches an ability would be nice, actually. I don't know if there's anything else, though. The MP plus 20 would be cool. Let's do the Guardian Mog skill. I remember that being pretty good. Oh, I didn't know that about the ladder. It's like one of the Cerberus Elite thingies. That's cool. There's an area in Mass Effect 3 that's a big reference to the events of the second Mass Effect book. Has a character, like, the main character of the books is there. Holly Sanders. My main playthrough is Paragon All the Way. I was just talking about how I feel like I'd like the Mass... I feel like Mass Effect 2 could have just made you choose there, and that may have been more interesting. Thank you, Risa, for the support. Risa just posted in Hitbox chat. Appreciate that. I'm still working on getting the Hitbox chat displayed on stream for all my different profiles. I have to go back and manually set it up. It's a little bit different for each of the different kind of screens I'm displaying, depending on what system I'm on. Have you played the Final Fantasy games before, Risa? I think we already got the thing that was up. Yeah, nothing new up there. Activated this thing that shows a picture of a planet with a red moon. PC Master Race. Very good. Good series if you like RPGs. You've played some of the other BioWare RPGs though, like Baldur's Gate. I guess you can be a Final Fantasy fan and member of the PC Master Race these days. Square has been porting most of their old games over. They have a few. I don't think 9 is available yet. Stone Killer could be nice. Give the judo uniform to you. You can play almost every Final Fantasy on PC now except for 9 and 10. I don't think 10's on PC yet. 11 was definitely... Yeah, it is basically a single-player MMO, that's exactly right. Is it Inquisition that you played, Risa? You go back and play the older ones like Baldur's Gate, it's a lot further from that. Hey Broken One, how you been, man? So Vivi and Ico's job can be to like kill those gargoyles if they show up since they're blocked using magic. Or it is. If you can find a way to like get a demo or something, give Inquisition a try. You might like it better. It still has the tanking mechanics, but I don't know, it's closer to Skyrim, but in a way that's tolerable for me. Like, I've mentioned before, I can't really play Skyrim-type games, Fallout-type games, not because they're bad, but just because, like, I obsessively need to 100% games, and they're very much built on, don't worry about 100%ing it, man, just kind of explore around and have fun. I forget what Guardian Mog actually does in this game. I don't know if someone in chat does. I think it does something like... I think it like bolsters protect, so it makes you immune to death and some of the things that a ribbon alone doesn't protect you from, but not 100% sure. Nothing. Gotta figure out that word. Ancient ship, oldest in history. 1 to 8. Ship building technology, primitive. Going well, having a pretty happy Thursday here, playing some awesome games. Yeah, that's what stresses me out, Risa. How many hours was your 100% Fallout playthrough, just like Fallout 3, for example? If you like those kinds of games, you'll probably like Inquisition quite a bit more, Risa. It feels much closer to the Skyrim style, with some quality of life improvements. And the, classic BioWare decision trees for conversations. I feel like everything in every BioWare game is just getting me to the next conversation. It's the meat of the game for me. I had Amarant defend an error, but it's fine. That's awesome. I'll be playing Fallout 3 whenever we get a release date for Fallout 4. I'll see if I can time playing through the two games before Fallout 4 comes out and blind play that on stream. I'm more liberated playing those kinds of games on stream because a lot of the, aggressively 100% the game is really boring to watch, so I don't feel compelled to do it as much as when I'm playing it solo. No, Burner? You don't like PC gamers? I think everyone should just be chill. Like, people can have fun whatever platform they're on. I think in this generation that, like, the correct consoles to own are a PC and a Wii U. Because it used to be that gaming consoles, like, they would sell them at a loss and they would have significantly more powerful graphics engines than a PC could have at comparable cost. But thanks to Moore's Law and the increasing demand for high-powered graphics cards, like, you can build a PC for roughly the same cost as a console, and it'll actually be more powerful in a lot of cases. This is the first time that's been true. And as a result, there are a lot of games that are no longer exclusive to consoles like there were back in the day. Well, the PC Master Race thing is, it's kind of silly that people have co-opted it and mean it seriously. I mean, it was originally from Yahtzee. You've checked out his zero punctuation videos. He was making fun of PC gamers by saying that, oh, we're the glorious PC Master Race. Y'all are console peasants. But for whatever reason, the people like took it to heart and thought, oh, that's funny. Let's just call ourselves that. Hey, Ninja Pig, how's it going? Yeah, we'll revisit that when our consoles become sapient. I agree, Kami. Getting offended at the phrase PC Master Race is getting offended to get offended. There's nothing. It was Yahtzee making fun of them and them co-opting it for themselves. It's fine though to be like, man, I don't like PC snobs that are mean to me and say that I can't enjoy my console games. I love console games and have been a console gamer since a kid. It's only recently that I built a computer. I hear you, Sysic Scenes. Oh, that's cool, Risa. I think that Matt in chat was telling me the same thing, that maybe I should just start with New Vegas, because it's a little bit more structured. I think that's kind of just what I need in the game. Like, I'll enjoy exploring for a while, but like, just structure it for me. Yeah, that's cool. This other world called Terra. I'm gonna learn more about this. This is pretty important to the end game plot. Also, where Final Fantasy IX starts to get a little bit weird. Here before. Can we open the door now? We can. Look at that. Success. Oh, whoa. This room is freaky looking. Oh, so you're saying play Fallout 3 first and then be impressed by New Vegas rather than the other way around? I could do that. I'm atop the stone. Interesting, Obsidian has had a pretty bad track record. Like, when they'll enter into somebody else's franchise or IP, and they will do the beginning, 80% of the game will be outstanding, but then there'll be lots of bugs, and it won't feel quite as polished. This has been true for a couple of the franchises they've picked up, but I've heard that there's been so much time for New Vegas to get patched that any of the issues are pretty much gone, and it's just a really solid game now. They just have a really aggressive development cycle or something. I don't know if you played Knights of the Republic, Risa, but it's like that. So this other planet called Terra that died, basically. Cool, Cloud Reaver. That's one of the benefits of being in a PC game, I suppose. More important things right now. Learning facts. The question then becomes, what does this red planet Terra have to do with our planet? I'm gonna pop outside and use a tent so I'm not dumping too many high potions. My cat is sitting right off screen, the counter on my right, moping that I haven't fed him yet, as is his way. Yeah, I probably have BB attack. It's pretty hard. He has one of his endgame weapons right now from the Chocobo Hot and Cold minigame. Nice. Auto region would be pretty good here. Cool. UQ. Rolling out of here. There's another door. I don't know if I've seen it before. I haven't played XCOM, but I know there are people in chat who have. Anyone able to help out or experience the issues you're running into? Not that I'm patronizing Broken Woman, but have you tried Googling XCOM crashes during cutscenes? I wonder if it's like an operating system issue or something. Are there something you can change? Like desktop composition in Windows 7 can cause crashes sometimes if you don't disable it for a specific application. Try casting meteor. PS3. Huh. Game freezes in cutscenes. Try to verify integrity of the game cache. I'm not sure how you do that on the PS3. That might be a Steam-only option. I don't know if you can like uninstall the game from your PS3 and reinstall it. You should be able to keep your save file if you do that. Is it one of those games where it saves it to your console? I know a lot of PS3 games do that, so maybe it's the installed version has some error somewhere. It probably couldn't hurt to reinstall there. Do you have regular items? He does. Good. You're not just screwed SOL with items when you get here. I have some more high potions. It's my main way of healing at the moment. 6. Make sure I'm actually saved too. I see. You can try connecting online and see if there's a patch or something to help with that. Yeah, that's sucky. Is there any way, do you have any friends that have a PS3? Maybe you could try borrowing theirs to see if the issue can be reproduced. Just to see if it's an issue with your console or the disc. I used to work in testing in a very specific way of looking into a problem like that. The ads are loud in Hitbox, Risa? That's good to know. I didn't know that. I've seen people mention that about Twitch ads as well. Cloud Reaver makes a point too. You might need to update both of them if you haven't already. Tried doing the Final Fantasy VII trick. It's only in 7, but if you get back attacked, you can press L and R to pretend like you're gonna run, and it flips you back around so you don't take double damage from the first hit you normally do. Medio Twister is probably good enough. Grand Label is probably overkill and a waste of MP, but I guess I wouldn't otherwise use. Cool, Risa. I might do that when I go feed the cats. Sometimes when I'll put myself away when I go feed the cats between the 4 o'clock and 6 o'clock block, I'll be like, so pretend that I'm partnered and that you're getting to watch a cutscene about, or a cutscene, an advertisement for Taco Bell right now. Alright, so he's got auto haste. Have somebody else start learning it. I want everyone to have auto haste eventually. Probably do auto reflect. I don't know if he's anywhere near having enough AP to equip auto haste. Needs 9. Yeah, we need to get like 2 more AP for that to be an efficient decision. We'll give him jelly since there are enemies in here that can turn you to stone. I could dump auto region for auto haste, but I feel like if anyone needs auto haste, it's these two knuckleheads. We can do that. What would I dump for it? Probably return magic. I mean, it's a cool ability, but it gets you in trouble more often than not. It basically makes him recast magic that's cast on him. But a lot of enemies cast the spell that they absorb, so like if a water elemental casts water on you, you're in trouble. I could add status for confuse on this thing. Yeah, that seems weird if they're both faulty, though. It seems like if you have two different games that are both having a similar issue, it seems more likely to me, even if they came from the same source, the problem is with the console. So if you're able to find someone who has another PS3, if you know that if you load a cutscene, it's probably going to crash, that would be how I would go about testing it. Yes, Risa, in a roundabout way, Pokemon is definitely turn-based RPG combat, so each character has a range of options they can select from. You pick which one you want to do, and that's the only action that they take. Most Final Fantasy games are not truly turn-based the way that Pokemon is. As you see, there's that little like turn indicator called the ATB, or Active Time Battle Meter, that basically decides when you get to take your turn compared to the monsters. But it's essentially turn-based. There's a couple of them that are, you know, more like the Pokemon style of turn-based, where, you know, someone gets to go, you have as much time as you want to come up with your turn decision, you decide, and the enemy gets to go, and so on. You have quite a few more options in Final Fantasy. I think each Pokemon has a maximum of, like, 4 moves they can use, right? Whereas in Final Fantasy, each of my characters probably has, like, 20 different things they can pick from. Yeah, it seems smart. Broken. Yeah, so that probably... You don't like turn-based RPGs in general. Final Fantasy is probably not for you. Do you like action RPGs a little bit more then? I don't know if you've played, well, I guess if you haven't had consoles, you wouldn't have played Kingdom Hearts. What's a good PC action RPG? I guess Bastion, kind of, but you don't really have, like, experience points in that. More of just, like, a action-adventure game. Is there, like, a Secret of Mana-style game that I'm forgetting? Cloud Reaver. Make sure you exercise your ghosts before you test it. Yeah, Fable's an action RPG. It's a good one. Secret of Mana will happen when Hapax and Matt are living out here and we have a weekend free to play it. I don't want to play it single player. Like, part of what makes that game so awesome and fun is playing it with three players. Hey, it's Ark. I think there's an important steal for this. The MMO combat is frustrating for a lot of people that I know. The whole thing is very opportunity cost oriented. Like, you know, with global cooldowns, there's only one thing that I can do. So really the answer is figuring out what the correct option to take is, and any other option is incorrect. I'll be stealing from this guy for a while. I think we've got enough high potions to keep everybody topped off. Cool. We want to steal this guy's best item, but we're going to set a time limit for how long we're going to try at it. Because it could take a long time, and these enemies have really hard items to steal. I'm going to say if we haven't stolen the final item by 240, we'll just go ahead and kill him. He might also just die, because whenever he uses that big attack, he's hitting everyone in the party. That, which sometimes triggers a counterattack from our main character, the Dane. I actually am not a big fan of RTS games. They stress me out too much. I always have this sense that I'm playing incorrectly or suboptimally. And a lot of the game is like using the most possible optimal use of your time. Oh, Aiko got confused, that's not good. So is Zidane, that's also not good. He hits really hard. Diablo, there you go. Diablo's action RPG. I don't know if you like Diablo or not, but that's a good example. Don't confuse. That might hit everybody and knock them out of confusion, we'll see. Aiko's still confused again. He's not. Perfect. MOBAs, yeah. My problem with MOBAs isn't the basic gameplay. The basic gameplay is actually kind of fun, but the barrier to entry is so high, and like the fact that they require that you play with other people means that if you're new to the game, you're gonna make 4 to 9 other people very unhappy if you're just trying to figure it out. You know, since the game is, you can't really practice against bots in those kind of games. They're all about playing the player, so to speak. Everybody got confused. If we get into this fight again, we like wipe because of this, I'll give everyone the ability that makes them immune to confusing. It's called clear-headed. I gotta play the Red Alert games. They have a bunch of awesome actors, right? they do a lot of live action cutscenes. I remember like Tim Curry's in one of them. Got kind of a funny, irreverent style. This might be bad. Good chance we're gonna lose this fight. Just owing to our lack of immunity to confuse. Our time limit here is 6 minutes to try to finish stealing everything from this guy. If we are unsuccessful, we're just gonna call it. And we're gonna finish him off. He just reduces his point. That's cool. Proctus, how you doing? Fight an arc here. It was actually a summon later in this game. Interesting, right? I think I mean like X potion. You can throw tents at enemies in this game and it gives them a bunch of status effects if it works. I can try using that on this guy. Status effects would certainly be convenient if they will land, but I'll try it. It's a weird mechanic. I think this is the only game that does that. Yeah, I get the sense that Reese's point, though, is that they don't really play console games, whether it's emulator or not. Yeah, I don't know if you've played... Oh man, look at that! Bitten by Silence, Darkness, and Poison Snake! They healed him to full, but it's okay, he's got a bunch of nasty status effects now. I wonder if that's a bug. It's really weird that it does that. Probably try to keep Vivi alive. The fact that it's poisoned might just kill it. That sometimes happens too. As our turns are going on, the arc boss is taking damage over time from poisoning it a second ago. So Shacker's probably not the best use of his turn. I forget what the last stealable item is from this guy. Don't think it's as nasty as some of the earlier enemies we've been trying to steal from, but still not easy to do. Really wants to hit Vivi with that for some reason. Look it up here. Arc. Shacker casting faster has comparable fun. Fortunately, this is the one that confuses us. Hopefully, it doesn't hit everybody. It hit almost everybody. Steal an elixir, a power vest, and a holy lance. Holy Lance isn't too rare. I just wait on him to use a physical attack to remove Confuse. Okay, that counts as an elemental attack and doesn't remove the status effect. It's not something you can recover with an item. You have to hit the party member with a physical attack to remove their Confuse. That's not good. Knock her out of it? Didn't. Cool. Assuming that Zidane doesn't kill her while confused. Okay. Go back to stealing. Hopefully they don't get confused again here with this next propeller wind. We die, it's a short run back. We've got 2 minutes on the steal attempts here. Hey Cam Man, how you doing? Boomerang will knock Vivi out, so that's good. hopefully before his action cues for the turn. Good, good, good. We're gonna pick Amarant up. We'll try using Revive. We got two more minutes of steal attempts. Try to get this item, then we'll just go for the kill. I went with Flamo because he has an ability that revives the party. So he's probably just going to get one shot by this attack here. Let's see if they can get out of this thing that they're in right now. Come on, party. Snap out of it. So that takes out Amarant, but they're still confused. And I can't do anything while they're confused. I just have to wait for them to hit themselves like they just did. Take this opportunity to bring Flamo back up. Okay, get in there. Vivi has auto life turned on, so if he dies once, he'll get back up. But I think it caps out there, you're not just invincible. I want him to have some hit points, so we don't. Well, he's gonna die here. Vivi gets back up. We try one more time to pick up the Flamo, maybe throw a high potion at him so we can actually get his revive off. And the problem so far, this guy likes to use AoE abilities. Good chance that Zidane will get his trance ability too at some point during this. If he does, he'll probably do enough damage to finish the fight off. It hits really, really hard. But we'll see. Don't confuse Flame. That was the opposite of what I told you to do again. Just high pushing him. At this point, it might just be best to go back to the save point. We'll see if this boomerang kills us. And equip people with the thing that makes them immune to confuse. And we'll just move on with our lives. Better throw an immediate high potion on him when he gets up this time. Had to wait for the animation to finish, apparently. Alright, so he dies again. Vivi's probably gonna go down from this one. Alright, later, Cloud Reaver. I'm just gonna go ahead and like punch myself to death. We'll restart. This time we'll equip everybody with a thing that makes them immune to confuse. We'll skip the stealing since we already passed our time limit for it. Burner, it looks like the Cecil from Final Fantasy IV is 16 by 24, so it's a little too tall. So I can either try to shrink the battle sprite, or I can use the overworld sprite as small enough, if you prefer. If you're like dead set on the battle sprite, I'll try to shrink it. Might not look very good, though. Cool, man. Next week, Wednesday or so. We'll do it for sure. I'm going to skip through those texts since we already saw it. Trying to merge the red planet and the blue planet that we're on into Minnie Mouse. Nice, Kami. Very nice. Oh, hopefully it's going to give me a second at the bottom of this thing to equip the anti-confuse ability. If it doesn't, I'll just reload again here. Sure it will. Yeah, okay. Let's do it. Clear-headed, I think it's called, right? Oh, these people need to actually have the skill. If he has it. He doesn't have it. She has it. So maybe it's, like, likely to only be learned by a mage? Through it. The way you learn abilities in this game is you equip gear and they teach it to you permanently. So you can just equip the gear to get access to it immediately. You can equip it longer term until you finish mastering the skill to have it equipped permanently. Magician shoes. Let's give it to him. It's jelly, I guess. Status book. Clear-headed prevents confusion. Perfect. You get the same treatment. Let's get rid of jelly. Clear-headed. Jelly, clear-headed. Perfect. You heal up the party this time. Never gonna use regular potions in battle. So I'm not going to devote myself to stealing, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to have Zidane steal on each of his turns, and everyone else will actually be trying to kill him. Maybe we'll just luck out and he'll get the Holy Lance. We'll see what happens. Not holding my breath. Probably should have Flamo heal himself next turn. Or no, I'll probably have Vivi or Aiko heal. Since they can't really do anything else at the moment. Makes sense. Most of his targets in the game, so. That was perfect. Perfect timing from the enemy. I'll keep that potion for now, I think it's correct. Nope, that's not good. Phoenix down, pick him up. She's just gonna waste, oh, I guess she won't totally waste it. Stealing train, we'll keep trying to potion him up to full. Go pinwheels. Pinwheel the giant airship boss to death. There we go. And I don't think that's gonna be wasted here. It's gonna suck, but. confusion protection is definitely the most important thing in this fight. Himself. And then Echo will just auto-regen back to full most of the time, so we don't need to worry too much about her. I think he might have a I just died attack, so we need to be a little bit careful around that. As long as Vivi has his auto-life, we should be okay, so we don't want Vivi to die at all, so we can recover immediately in case that happens. Not gonna get one shot by and well, some things could still one shot him. He might survive. Let's see. Yeah, just barely. Pinwheel. Burner, your icon should be good to go. If you wanted to test it. Try doing a shrunken version of the battle sprite instead of using the overworld sprite. Oh, good. Yeah, he's not like Amaranth. Yeah, Mega Man, you're there in like an hour. We're gonna go with. Do you want to have the Mega Man X? It's a level up if you wanted to see. You want to go with a Mega Man X head? Like the one up? Probably fit that in. There's the power vest. We got that first try last time. Hey, there you go, Burner. You can only see it on stream, but there it is. Cool, cool. I will try it. It'd be a good fight to try it since I'm just kind of waiting on the boss to die. That one's perfect. That one's 16 by 16. I'll get it set up here in a sec. You get a custom in-stream chat badge once you pass the 240 hours watch mark. Hey, we got the last item. Okay, cool. Well, we can just kill him now. We don't have to worry about waiting to steal. Perfect. Excellent. Oil Lance is pretty good, if I remember, too. Poor Amaranth. I wonder if there's, like, just coincidence that he keeps hitting Amaranth, or if it's based on some rule, like how many hit points they have. Got him! And we got all the items. GG Arc. Schedule update, we're going to be playing Final Fantasy IX for another hour and 8 minutes, and then it's Terra Battle, which is the new free-to-play mobile game from Hironobu Sakaguchi, the creator of Final Fantasy, that features music from Nobuo Uematsu, the awesome composer of the main series Final Fantasy games, before 11. Bullock Stone. This is a part that I think if you screw it up, you have to start all the way back from the beginning. Like, you have to go all the way back and do the arc fight again. So I'm going to try to do this very, very carefully so as not to screw it up. See if it gives us a save point. Calm down, Steiner. Great. Sweet, adorable morons. Welcome back, Johan. Oh man, get ready. Sid hype. Turn them all on. Yeah, so we don't want a game over here. If we do, we have to do that whole arc boss fight all over again, so... Send your gaming prayers my way. Pray to RNGesus. Bound fat hedgehog there. This is red light, green light, if you've played that before. Crap. Okay. It's harder than it looks, man. Sometimes he turns around really fast. Oh my god, I was so close to it. I'm gonna die here. We're gonna have to do that boss fight again. Okay. Cool. Phew! Wood. We don't want to use the lightest weight one. I would guess that they're weighted in order from left to right there. right? You want it to be as heavy as possible so that it can hold up Cid. Like, there's no penalty for it being the heaviest possible amount. Yeah, there we go. Phew! So iron, stone, and clay should all be heavier than wood. God. I was so sure it was game over, man, after I screwed it up like 5 times. Phew! There's your Mega Man head, by the way. Mega Man X, it fit perfectly. I think it looks pretty good. No time to celebrate. Sure, sure. Okay, I'm gonna go try to find a save point. A lot of stuff has happened so far, and no saving. Anything worthwhile at the Mog Shop? Exobably not. That's how tiny this whole thing actually was. Look how tiny little scales were. Like, why would Kuji even leave those there? The answer is video game. Mog Sam, sure. Pretty much. There might be one or two other ones. I guess there's other parts where you don't have Zidane, but they put Marcus in your party so that you have a thief to be able to try to steal some stuff. It's actually kind of a relief to not have to worry about it for a second. Oh, I want all those things. White draw takes MP, I think. Restores MP of all party members. I'm gonna finish learning that. That's really strong. A little bit faster. Red really, really fast. Probably won't be using Queen as seriously this game. Working on Leviathan. Queen up here. Or there. Probably do the Diamond Sword. Genji Helm, Gauntlets, Demon Mail. No, I don't feel too bad about not getting that earlier. There's a boss fight where you can steal the Demon Mail, and I kind of screwed it up. But it looks like it's really not that big of a deal. How low level these party members are. This game is of order 40, 50 hours, maybe? I'm at 29 hours, and I'm maybe 3/4 of the way through it, so we'll probably beat it in the next 10 hours of play or something. About halfway through Disc 3. Oh man, Desert Palace. Right, this whole part's non-trivial. There's like a boss that you disable its defenses by getting all the items in this dungeon, I think. It seems right. It's been a while since I've done it. Promised ring. Okay. I think we've made this a little bit easier on ourselves by coming here later. Like how we made the last dungeon hard because we brought some magic users. Well, this will be a little bit easier now that we don't have magic users with us. You could end up having a party that's just 4 magic users. Yeah. Hey, mind flayers. Guys also show up in Final Fantasy 14. Maybe the way Mustard Bomb works is that if you take damage while you're affected by that, you just die instantly. Oh, if you act at all. Gotcha. So she already had an attack queued, and that's why she died. Sure. I'm using Mantra Magic. Is this the one where it, like, reduces them to 1 point? That's less good. Learn that Aqua Breath is pretty bad. Knight's pretty bad. We'll just have her physically attack. Try eating them. Probably want to equip everybody with body boots so that they're immune to this attack. It's pretty nasty. So, Queena would have died there if it hit her. And they just, like, spam cast that. It's pretty bad. Using to have her not do anything if we want her to survive. Leave it to Steiner and Frail. Clunky and Liara. I don't know if that actually does more damage. Doesn't do any damage. Don't do that in the future, it's a waste of a turn on a non-boss. I feel like this whole dungeon is like teaching you, hey, you should probably equip body temp on all your party members. That one you can recover, I think, if you use fire magic on the frozen character. Might be the only way to pick her up. I don't think they have any other way. They only have a way to just use fire damage on her for free, unfortunately. I think she just snaps out of it eventually as well. Lancer ignores when they're vanished like that, they avoid all physical damage, so you can use an ability to circumvent that, basically. Yeah, I'm probably gonna have to back up back to that Moogle and heal up a little bit. Well, we got a lot of things we have to do, let's just take care of all of it. At least we can cast magic now. That is very convenient. So, first of all, who has body temp? He does already. She does not. She does, or it does already, I guess. I don't know what its gender is. She doesn't. Sure. Monkey, so Freya needs it. Just Freya? Everyone else has it. Freya, you lucky girl. Teaches body temp. Must be an accessory. Chemist? Anything else that teaches it? Oh, it's a fairy earrings, that's why they all have. Alright, well, I'll take the one that gives Chemist, that's fine. He has auto region right now, which is quite nice. We're gonna have to dump cover, though. I'll do add status. I don't think her current weapon has a status effect on it. Oh, disregard. That's actually pretty good. I'm gonna run back to the Moogle to use a tent real quick. Try to unlock all the cool items you can get in this dungeon that also make the next boss a little bit easier. Yeah, exactly, Mega Man. These guys use poison, kind of like cousins of the Koi Earl. interestingly, if you have Eiko in your party, she's automatically the party leader. If you don't have Eiko in your party, then Vivi's automatically the party leader. So I think this is the first time I've ever done this where I've seen Steiner running the party, because we didn't have either Eiko or Vivi. I don't know who it would be if you also sent Steiner, maybe Freya. Yep. I don't know what the canon pronunciation of that word is supposed to be. Curl? I always said co-earl. It slows, that's really great. Man, the poison on Rex is super nasty. If we can fit antibody onto her. It. Douche lines. Marble mouth coral. Carl. So I should just call them Carl, is what you're telling me. Slow added effect is kind of good. I guess I could drop Millionaire, but I like having money. Anyone else get antibody for free? He already has it, so... that's fine. Drop cover. Well, drop bug and bird cover. That's more like it. She can probably afford it. Yeah, maybe not. Because like, I don't want to have all those other things that are on her right now. Yeah. Carl form. Oh, it's good, Mega Man? Cool. Oh, Matt, you're pretty close. Yeah, everyone's kind of converging on the 2 or 40 hour mark. Do you have a sprite that you wanted? So I need to get Hapax to pick one. I think he still has a placeholder Final Fantasy finger cursor. 18 by 18. I can do some shrinking. Like, Burners looks pretty good, even though it's been shrunken a little bit. Okay, so these guys, depending on the thing that's at the top, they're weak against a different element. So I think the one that's red on the top is weak against physical. I was incorrect. It is the opposite. It might change up when you do that, though. The one that's blue on the top is weak against physical. Try Eno. I think they might just teach Magic Hammer or something. Cool, man. Check spritersresource.com. I think I dislike EAT as a mechanic for, yeah, learning abilities. Kind of hard to follow when you shouldn't use it. Man, this whole level is like status effect town. And you just got stopped. This is one of the games with the most brutal status effect requirements. There's a lot of effects that count as a death. Like stop, if your whole party gets stopped, it's game over. You can try using Patcher Magic on that guy. Hey, Pax, how you doing, man? Dude, even do it when it's unsuccessful. Give me something for it. M- That might kill them, we'll see. Who can eat till it's weaker? We'll have to make some room to equip locomotion on everybody, I guess. Try using Aqua Breath. We really gotta get like a bread and butter magic attack for Quina. Doesn't really have one at the moment. No, it actually hit. Lucky us. Throw out the party and try to eat it again. This battle music remains my favorite regular battle music, like the one that you hear in most of the game. Tastes bad. You'd have to be kind of goofy about it. You have to paste it into, like, paint and then do a select on it to see how many pixels it is. But if you compare, Mega Man's head is 16 by 16, so roughly that level of complexity. The Final Fantasy 4 or 6 character is, like, in the battle sprite is 16 by 24. So they're a little too tall, but you can shrink them down, they're usually recognizable. And if we get these ball guys again, yeah, I'm gonna have to switch and give people locomotion. At least one person. I want to make sure at least one person in the party cannot be, like, killed in one hit by these things. Oh, that puts our party to sleep too. Shit, especially if they're immune to sleep. Oops. I think the intended use of that ability is that you only use it if you have party members that are immune to sleep. Which we don't. Now the waiting game. I don't know if there's a stat that influences how quickly you wake up from being asleep. Thought I was being so clever, neutralizing the opposition. Not so much. There we go. Lancer doesn't actually drain MP, I think it just damages MP. She has antibody already. Yeah. Actually, the game with the strongest blue magic is Final Fantasy XI. Blue mages get solo content intended for like 6 people. They're actually quite good in Final Fantasy V as well. I really need to get some kind of, like, fight attack magic for Dagger. It would help immensely if she hit Holy. Leviathan's is a little too expensive for what it does. But you have to have them, like, sub 10% health to eat them. Yeah. Blue Mage is an extremely strong class in Final Fantasy V. Very useful abilities. One of these is body tech. Okay. Let's do that. Max Azuli. Absorb MP, I guess. I'm not actually entirely sure how that works, but absorbs MP used by the enemy. Okay, that's kind of cool. Alright, so we need someone who can be immune to stops. That's locomotion. Probably gonna end up being Dagger. I don't need to worry as much about silence. There's nothing I can drop. I guess I can drop Chemist. We can also remove silence from the pool. Yeah, I don't like when each character needs to learn the spell separately. or 9, yeah. 10 was a limit break. 8 was a limit break. I think that weakens blue magic pretty significantly. Yeah. Not a fan. One of my favorite things from 10 that I want to see a game bring back is the concept of overkill bonuses. That was genius, man. Like, too often you get too strong in a game and you don't feel anything when you're going back and fighting weak opponents. Basically, it gave you bonus XP for killing an enemy that you did way more damage than their hit points. Schedule update, we're going to be playing Final Fantasy IX in another 40 minutes, and it's Terra Battle, the free-to-play mobile game from Hironobu Sakaguchi, the creator of Final Fantasy. You should check it out. Oh, what game is that? I like how for all of their like BS going back and forth with Lalafell racism and riffing on each other, like Matt and Kami have really similar interests. Oh, interesting. It's one of the V games that I get confused. Valkyria Chronicles, Valkyrie Profile, Vagrant Story, and at least one other one that starts with V. But mentally, they occupy the same space in my head as a V game that I haven't played yet. That's good. Alright, look at that. Frozen. Game over. I feel like you should be able to eat them if they have like a battle ending status effect like Frozen. Oh, I see. So Frozen is if you hit them, they die. The other one, Heat, is if they move, they die. That's awesome, Matt. I want to play that. Let me see what Dragon's Crest does. I want to use it. Does physical damage to the enemy. I kind of would prefer Dragon's Breath. Let's see what Luna does as well. Luna causes Berserk to all targets. Oh, no, no. Dragon Breath do magic damage, but that would be swell. No, you know, that's not so great, but that's the best thing I'm going to be able to equip for the moment, unfortunately. It kind of petrify that you have to hit them one time to kill them. Really, it's more important for use by the enemies, so it gives you a chance to cure it before they kill you. Being stuck here? I guess we'll see. Maybe I'm thinking of a similar dungeon in Kingdom Hearts. I'm gonna delete all of these decks. I'm gonna go back over there and see if that's something I can access. Cool song, I forget the name of it, from FF9. Can I not light this yet? Ah. There we go, we gotta do that one last, I guess. They make it seem like, I feel like the way they should have done it is if you take the item, then the boss gets harder, but they did it the other way around, where if you take the item, the boss gets easier. So you get the best of both worlds. Luminous Arc, that sounds familiar. Is that kind of the same thing? Nah, bro, a mustard bomb's not gonna work. We got body temp now. Foolish child. Foolish. Foolish sucker. Yeah, yeah. Freeze just freezes? I don't know if it does damage too. I've heard people who really, really like, what is it, Disgaea? Disgaea? Never played them myself. They're like really, really long games too, right? Almost got Leviathan, then we can sub it out for something else. Okay, is a cleavage? Oh, okay. Which one's the cleavage RPG? I mean, cleavage games can be good. I will, like, relentlessly complain about how bad it is that they do that in every single game, but I think that's a feature that's bad enough to make a game not playable, unless that's really all that the game is about. Luminous Arc, gotcha. Dude, that is bookmarked, Tommy. Let's try doing a cure on everybody. Disregard. Some of those rare games where all status effects are removed at the end of combat. Got Leviathan now. We can start learning something different. Do Atomos. Shiva or Ifrit. Anything else that would be particularly sexy? Auto life, maybe. She's a good one to have auto life. Can't invest too much in her at the moment, at least for this dungeon, because she has this problem because she's quiet. She loses her concentration occasionally and can't attack. We'll just do them in ascending order of how much AP they cost. Got tons of ethers, so dump those. The hardest bosses ever, that sounds awesome. Love hard bosses. Just gonna hit this thing. Yes. She What you got? Shield armor. There it is. Is that better than demon mail? Wait, not quite. That would be pretty frustrating if it was. Demon mail has some kind of drawback. Magic defense on it is sucky, but the physical defense is top-notch. So I don't think I've actually been stuck here. I think there's a familiar zone to this, like Hollow Bastion in Kingdom Hearts 1. Really easy to get stuck and lost. For a long time, I said that the system that had the highest quantity of the highest quality games was the Super Nintendo. It might be the DS now. Like, if you include the GBA catalog. Very high quantity of high quality games. Hey, jump still hits. That's good to know. Do you guys say Disgaea or Disgaea? Or Disgaea? I would say Disgaea. Oh yeah, he just picked it up, didn't he? He's been having crazy times at work lately. Maybe we'll see him. Disgaea? Okay. There's a Moogle up here somewhere. I think I'm making that up. Bale? Nice. That's a lot of HP. Yeah. Wow. That's crazy. Oh, you can only have one of them open, I get it. I want to go in that one just yet. E2 Bale, man. Usually he'd die in one hit. Get into a pickup party with a... I think we need to hit all these. Pickup party with a hammered-in bot. I think that's the boss up at the end there. So we want to go there just yet. I could have sworn there was a Moogle in this area. I might be misremembering. Thought that was true, though. We'll see. Go back down here. Hey, Kuja. Good to see you again. Interesting. There's a... Bloodstone I want to access, that's up there. You can only depower them in order. Oh, I bet you it's the left. It looks like there's more screen over there. Yeah, look at that. Secret Moogle. I found a secret Moogle. Another 27 minutes of FF9. We'll probably beat this dungeon a little bit after that. Then it's time for the next game, Terra Battle. If you haven't seen it before, I recommend you check it out. Nobuo Uematsu is a soundtrack. Gameplay lead design by Hironobu Sakaguchi, creator of Final Fantasy. And it's super neat. Good God, Mega Man. I wonder how long that fight takes. I don't know if you can top the 18-hour Absolute Virtue fight in Final Fantasy XI, but it doesn't really count. Got us working in shifts. Oh no, I had body temp on. Too bad. Mind flare, dude. Do something special to enter this area over here. What's up, Mog Sam? I got a letter for you from Mojito. Let's open on a quest found Mog Sam. Cool. Agree. Oh, that's tent. Aggressive game saver. One too many power outs ruin an evening. Interesting. Okay. I'd like to control for strong power or something from leaving the base panel. That sounds like a pretty interesting boss. I might need to play that game. Left, I guess. Cool. Does this do anything, though? Oh, I see. So we got a... It's supposed to be a hint that one of them is a demon statue and one of them is an angel. This wants to be the one we want to follow. You could just brute force that. Oh, I figured it out just there. This is close to the boss, so we don't want to go this way yet. How does he go from weakest to strongest, Mega Man? Oh, I see. Gotcha. Kind of like with Bravely Default, where you can change the ability at will. Nice. Get Shiva. Favorite Shiva is Final Fantasy X, where she does the finger snap. My wife was playing it, she always tried to time her own finger snap with Shiva. She does it in Final Fantasy XIV, too, in a cool cutscene. Great. sweet. You keep casting Shiva, it's fairly cheap. I think the Steiner's gonna kill this last one. Carl. Earl. Maybe you're supposed to say Co-Earl like a southerner says Carl. Carl. Level 4 holy. There are some Final Fantasies where like there's an enemy that's really tough, but if you use like the level X death or level X petrify on them, you can trivialize them. I don't have any of those fights memorized. Awesome. How many Disgaea games are there? Just Curl. Curl. It's certainly not Co-Earl, I'm just pronouncing all the letters, doing it phonetically. Fun phonics worked for me, kind of thing. Not a real world word, it's not like a real mythological creature, is it? Shiva, that worked pretty well. They might actually be weak against ice. Oh, damn. According to Japan, it's Co-Earl. You pronounce the C-O-E as Co, and then the end is U-R-L, Earl, Co-Earl. Prinny is the penguin, right? I've seen that before. Try landing one more heat. Well, I think we already got them. These are the ones that have, these are the ones that teach level 4 holy. Is that really what it's called, Mega Man? Funny. Gotcha. Yeah. Co. Might be all the Bloodstone. I don't think I missed any. I didn't see anything that was like glowing that we weren't able to access earlier. Pretty funny. Thought this was a secret up here, but it's totally not. It's the way forward. Hey Ben, Cat Hype. Can I help you, buddy? Why haven't you fed me? I'm miserable. Oh, I'm not done yet? I've sworn I was. Must have. to go find out what I'm missing. I don't want to do that because that removes the entrance. Gotta be missing one. Oh, interesting, Mega Man. Consistent, like, secret boss they have. That's cool. Am I supposed to turn that off? Go back and see if I can find an obvious candelabrum that I'm missing. Might be one on, like, the right side of that thing. If it's supposed to be symmetrical, would make sense. There'd be something on the right there. Oh, I missed this one. Oops. Just ran right past it. Gamble, see if they're weak against, if they're level 4 multiples. Pretty cool, man. No such thing. We're weak against physical at the moment. Hey, D-Rock, how you been? Tommy wanted to know how 999 was coming. Be a pretty good source of damage. This isn't gonna do any damage since they're both physical right now. Poor Fawzi, man. No, it wasn't too bad. It's nerfed. Should do more damage this time, I would hope. Huh. I didn't know that was Disgaea's way. Naming enemies, things like that. That's cool. Try Aqua Breath, but man, it never does what I want it to do. Try to see if Shiva finishes it off. Cool. We got about 13 minutes left in FF9. I'm gonna give it its. We'll try to finish this dungeon if it takes us a little more time, we'll see. I think we'll be okay. I think that's the last one. Why does they even make this, like, place transversible? Go! Boss fight time. We'll be able to land some Leviathans. If I remember right, this boss is weak against water. This is a PlayStation 1 game. I'm playing it on a PS3. I got an HDMI connection with it. Final Fantasy X is PS2. Looks really good for a PS1 game. It's one of the last games on the system. Enhancing defense systems. What's active? I think I got all. These are all good things. Boss gets upgrades for all the bloodstones that you did not find. Perfect. Got all of them. Don't know if he's weak. Try off it, but just such bad accuracy. Night, Yahan. Sleep well. Thanks for hanging out. Big stinky ghost. Thundaga. Could be bad. Especially bad because, like, daggers are being damaged with this fight. It wasn't really that bad at all. Never mind. Aqua Breath! I'm actually hit this time. I don't know, get... Something's up with the formula for that one. I've never seen a Final Fantasy where Acrobeth has, like, an accuracy component. It just always hits. I'll try casting it one more time. See what I like this with the summon animations. Occasionally it shows you the whole animation. So you can be in awe of the cool-looking Leviathan. It's not all the time. Reflect. Well, we can't reflect the sun, so deal with that. Man, fail. Dagger can't concentrate. Man, I ain't even trying to hear that. Much damage that does. Seems like it could be because it had the failed upgrade. But it does do a little damage. Ether at dagger. Be dead? Alright. Woo! We beat the big wall thing. I don't know what the thing's supposed to be. It's kind of cool looking though. The closest thing I've done to a fantasy sport is a magic draft. A similar concept. Most of it's automated these days, right? Oh, I think it's letting me go back and save. Oh, too late now. Okay. No, I guess I still can do that. I don't think there's another boss after that one, but just in case. Never know. Nisha shield. Oh, counter. That's convenient. Give him something else to work on at the same time. Power belt's not the worst choice. Maybe a black belt. I have no problem with a lot of it being automated. That sounds great. Like, one of my biggest problems with Dungeons & Dragons and Magic is that it's on the players to adjudicate the rules, and if, like, a Magic computer could just be sitting there telling you how to resolve everything, that would be fantastic. Hmm. Was there ever a win, like, or did the rise of fantasy sports coincide with the rise of computers, or was there ever a point where people were having to, like, manually compute their players' score from game to game? Sounds like you have enough of a awareness of what's going on, so that, like, if something good happens in a game, you know that that's giving you points without actually looking at the app. Yeah, I'm doing it manually? Cool. Yeah, it blows my mind that that's, like, a totally mainstream activity. It's so nerdy. Well, I guess, I don't know, the last two decades have kind of been ruled by the nerds. Whenever I'll use that up carrot to me and I agree with the thing that that person just said, I always see the, like, anime eyes, like the hee hee. I saw it used that way for the longest time. Alright, let's here, maybe, question mark. Both magic. Man, full summon for Fenrir. Cry. For some reason in this one, he summons a big, like, owl statue that, like, punches you in the face. Oh, wow, copy. Copy, that's awesome. Just gonna attack that guy. This is gonna whiff on the one on the right. That's a Dane, might kill him. That's Canada for you. I guess certain parts of the states, they care that much about American football. It's pretty cool, Kami. Kami. Safe travels. Do a fantasy blitzball draft. If and when they finally add blitzball to Final Fantasy XIV, hopefully they'll let people who don't actually play do drafts. It would be fun. Shit, you know, if they ever added Blitzball, do you think they'd make it multiplayer, like, five players versus five players? I feel like they could do it. You'd have to do it in a way where skill was relevant, but there was some amount of RNG. I don't know, that'd be really interesting. I love when anyone is tasked with converting something that exists in one medium into another medium. Even just adapting a book into a TV show is one of the obvious ones. Or making a video game out of a movie. It's very challenging, and you can come up with some very clever ways to convert one thing to the other while still retaining its spirit. That's why I like Hearthstone a lot. If you've played any of the dungeons in World of Warcraft that the cards and adventures are based on, they do a really good job of retaining the spirit of the original fights. We're going to run over a little on time here with Final Fantasy IX before Terra Battle. Let's see if I can score a Moogle. We'll just save at the next possible moment. I don't think there's a fight associated with this. Yeah, Kocha. Okay, see you, D-Rock. Friends better be alright. Oh, great. Gulug is a reference to Final Fantasy I. There's a Mount Gulug in that game. Hey, they were fine. An illusion. Way to go, Ikko. That's not good at all. Ah. We've won yet. Get him, Sid. Need to do DLC and Sid as a battle character. What a dick. Kuja might be one of my least favorite Final Fantasy villains. I mean, Ultimisha doesn't really count, because she's one of the ones you don't really know about for most of the game, so if you don't know who else I'd sub in. Dagger, even though she has concentration problems at the moment. I don't know if there's actually gonna be any special items in here. Check just in case. Oops. I don't know if you're allowed to return here after you leave. Naming way card. Cool. I believe that card, let me see if I can get to it. Looks like the naming way from Final Fantasy IV. Yeah, it's the exact same sprite from FF4. It's cool. It's a character that changes your name. He lives on the moon. You see him in a few other places. Battles? Really? Alright. Okay, game. Hey, it's a color roll. It's Carl. I don't know how badly this game punishes you if you just make the absolute worst decision and bring all magic users to Oilvert. There's a way for you to get out of that. I suppose it's technically winnable. It'd be very, very slow. How you been, Anthony? Been a while. How you been? see ya. Let's go out the other exit this time, right? This one? Maybe? No, not this way. This is in case I missed anything. But there is a save Moogle down here, so let me go hit that. We should be able to just get out of here when we play tomorrow. Perfect. Alright, it's gonna be Terra Battle time. I'm about 5 minutes over in Final Fantasy IX, so it's gonna be a couple minutes to get Terra Battle turned on. I'm gonna throw on the BRB in the meantime. We'll be back in a few minutes.